motions of the bus ladder crunching. It consists of two sliding pair and two turning pairs. So there are three important motions of the bus ladder crunching. These are elliptical trammel, scotch shock mechanism, and Oldham's coupling. First one, elliptical trammel. This is an instrument for drawing ellipses. Here, the slotted link is fixed. The sliding blocks P and Q move in vertical or horizontal slots respectively. The end R generates an ellipse with displacement of sliders P and Q. The slot is used to draw ellipses. Where the slotted link is fixed, the sliding block P and Q move vertical horizontal slots respectively. The end R generates an ellipse. Displacement of the sliders P and Q. The coordinates of the point R are X and Y. So from the figure 1.16. You see it on 1.16. Cos theta is x upon r equation 1. Sin theta is y upon qr equation 2. Squaring and adding 1 and 2, we have x square upon pr square plus y square upon qr square equals to cos theta plus sin square theta. So x square upon pr square plus y square plus qr square equals to 1. This equation is out of ellipse, as instrument is an ellipse. The tracing point R is assumed to be midpoint. Then the midpoint PQ. Then the path traced by R is circle in case P equals to QR. So it's x square plus PR square plus y square plus y equals to 1. This equation is of a circle of PR square equals to its radius. This mechanism is scotching mechanism with figure 1.17. In this figure, the slider P is fixed, as we see on the left figure. The PQ rotates about P. The slider Q slides, reciprocates in a vertical slot. This mechanism is used to convert the rotary to reciprocating motion. Third is Oldham's coupling. This third motion is obtained by fixing link 2, that is the connecting link connecting the two blocks P and Q. if the two, if one block is turning through an angle, so the other block also turns through the same angle. Figure 1.18a. Application of the third version of the slider triangle is old Lamb's coupling, as shown in 1.18b. This coupling is used for connecting two parallel shafts. The distance between the center line shaft is small. Two flanges, each having a certain SS, are kept on one on each shaft. These flanges form link 1 and link 3. The intermediate disc having tongues on right angles, opposite sides, is placed in between the flanges. The intermediate piece from the link 4, which slides or reciprocates in flanges 1 and 3. The link 2 is fixed as shown. The flange 1 turns. The intermediate disc 4 must turn through the same angle, whatever angle 4 turns through. The flange 3 must turn through the same angle. Hence 1, 4, 3 have the same angular velocity at every instant. The distance between the X shaft is X. It will be the diameter of the circle traced by the center of the intermediate piece. The maximum sliding speed of each turn is given by V equals to X omega, where omega is angular velocity, V is linear velocity of the